Dear game devs, stop selling me your beta. Look, I know that a lot of people in video game media have been berating you for selling unfinished games. Games that were obviously not ready for release. Games that don't have tons of content. And it would be easy for me to do a video where I talk about that, but instead, I want to talk directly to the publishers. I want to talk directly to the developers of those games to explain why this is bad for you. And I'm going to try to do it in terms that you can understand. Maybe it's not very effective to talk about how it negatively impacts us, the consumers, but I know that you will understand when I tell you how it is going to affect you in a very real and personal way. In your wallet. We're talking about money! Ducats! Bling! Yeah! That stuff! Right now, the current thinking is that we will just sell an incomplete game, and one day down the road, after we do a roadmap of content or do some updating, there will be enough content in there for players to actually enjoy. And we'll just tell them that that content is going to be coming out, and therefore everybody will be happy. Except that that is not a sustainable market. Go on a little bit of a journey with me. Let's say you're buying a house, right? And the real estate agent takes you through this house and tells you exactly what the list price of the house is going to be, and that you need to pay the entirety of that list price right up at the front. And then gives you the disclosure that the plumbing isn't in, the electric isn't in, half the roof is done, we're gonna need trim, there really isn't a basement, and I think somebody mentioned something about insulation, we're not really sure. But don't worry, because all those things are gonna be taken care of in the next 6 to 12 months. Now my question to you is, would you buy that house? Think about that. Would you buy that house? Me, I'm asking a question, why don't I just come back and think about purchasing this house in 6 to 12 months once all of those things are installed? Now, if we were talking about a housing market, there might be a bidding war. Maybe other people are going to jump in on it to begin with because they're worried that it's going to be gone, that somebody else is going to snatch it up, and maybe the price seems reasonable. But now imagine that literally there are hundreds of these houses that are exactly the same with the exact same problem. Plenty for anybody who would possibly be in the market for them. Now, do you really want to buy the second that house comes on the market? Do you? No, chances are you're just going to wait until the house is complete. And then, well, the only possible thing that could happen is the house is cheaper now. And this is not out of the realm when it comes to video games. Let's go to everyone's favorite punching bag, Fallout 76. Well, one of their favorite punching bags. Fallout 76 was released last year to reviews. Yeah, that's fair. In almost every way, shape, and form, it was obvious that the game was really not a complete experience, that it was lacking a lot of actual content. And yeah, there were lots of bugs and glitches and problems, which Bethesda is pretty well known for, but also that Bethesda was going to have to fix it themselves. They couldn't rely on a modding community to do it, and they obviously hadn't done that. They had essentially put out a beta for a lot of their pre-registered people, people who bought the game before they could actually play it, but even that didn't seem to render a ton of results by the time it went out into the market proper. Due to a lukewarm reception, that's kind of being generous, from both the critics and from the audience in general, they started to realize that yes, indeed, we do have to produce more content. So they produced a roadmap of content, laying out all of the big updates that they would be putting into the game over the next several months. Some of it nearly a year out. And yet here we are basically half a year from its initial release, and a game that was once worth $60 on retail can pretty much be snatched up for $20. Last time I checked, $20 was less than $60, Bethesda, and you would have probably preferred that more people were buying it at the $60 price point instead of the $20, because that's money, revenue. And revenue's good, right? In the meantime, though, you still have another problem. You've already announced all this content that you have to put into the game. So guess what? Your dev team still has to produce all of that content. You know, the same stuff that they would have had to produce before the game released anyway. Here's my basic point. In this particular case, what you see is a game developer that has had to use all of the same resources and money to produce a game, but has lost 2/3 of its market value before the year mark is there, before all the content is even out. That's bad. You still have to put all the resources that you were planning on putting into the game into the game, and at the same time are selling it for a fraction of what you were hoping to get for that product. Which leads us to the other cautionary tale, and yes, BioWare, sorry, but you have to get in here at some point. Anthem is a game that I recently played, and it is fine. It's fine. It's not great. It's not horrible, but it's okay. It doesn't really do anything innovative or new that I appreciated. It's basically Destiny, like original Destiny, because even Destiny 2 didn't even have all the features of Destiny. The point is, it wasn't great, and definitely not what people thought it was going to be. More recently, BioWare, you had shown what you were hoping to be the big reveals of what the game had to offer, and yet it doesn't really look like what we thought we were going to get. And that's problematic, because this leads to another problem when a game studio starts stepping away from a project. And it's not hard to understand why you would be doing that, BioWare. I mean, we do expect that you're going to be talking about Dragon Age 4 soon, and if you're going to be doing that, chances are you have most of your team working on that project. So now we have come in with the promise that there will be more content in the future. People have bought your game and now realize, well, maybe that content's just not coming at all. These are two sides of the same coin. Either you are willing to put in all the time and effort to create a complete game, at which point you might as well have just completed the game before you released it, or you sell gamers on the fact that there will be more content and then fail to produce it afterward. Both of these models do not produce revenue. Not in the long term. Maybe possibly in the short, but never in the long. Because this isn't just about those projects, it's also about all the projects that come afterward. The only reason that games like Fallout 76, Anthem, or Sea of Thieves, for instance, are able to get the numbers of people out to buy them in the first place is because of the level of goodwill and trust that those game companies have developed with their audience over many years. And I got bad news for you. That trust, that respect, that goodwill, it has now been expended. It is gone, and looking to the future, I cannot see gamers, by and large, willing to jump on board with whatever the new project is that you have coming out. Because now, we've all been conditioned that the game is not going to be complete until 6 to 12 months after its release. And thus, we're not going to buy it when it comes out. Oh sure, there's still going to be some early adopters, and it will depend on the game and the studio that's creating it, but it is not going to be the numbers that you are used to. And I know, the reason why you keep putting these games out sooner than they really should be put out is because you have investors, and you have quarterly earnings reports, and you have all of this stuff that you have to use to show the money people that you're making money. But in the end, you will disappoint them too. Because down the road, there will be no money to be had. All of the money that's going into the industry will start to go to smaller studios or independent ones that might be producing less expensive, but also complete experiences. This is unsustainable for the long term. Your investors are going to start to realize that there are diminishing returns over and over again because no one trusts that the game that they're going to have in their hands is actually a game, and not just a tech demo. One of the only reasons that Sea of Thieves, created by one of the great game studios of all time, Rare, was able to get the number of people playing it is because it was part of Game Pass. So, like, if you already had Xbox Game Pass, you already had the game for free. There was no inherent costs. But you can't imagine that that would help your profit margin. More and more of the studios out there are taking on this model that it is just acceptable to produce and release an unfinished game. A big, vacant, open game with very little content, on the promise that we will eventually put it in if you wait long enough. But I don't want to. I would much rather that the game come out in 6 months when the game is complete, because then I know that when I pick it up, it is the experience I was looking for. Because you also leave a sour taste in the mouths of everybody who goes out and buys it for full price on day one. They get the game and they feel disappointed after they've played it for a while because it becomes obvious that it's not everything that they were hoping for, and now they're just going to have to sit around and wait for the game to be good. Once upon a time, we would just get a game, and it would be a game. Like, you would pick up the disc, and you would put it in the machine, and it would be the game. The whole game. And there were no bells and whistles to put on top of it. There was no downloadable content. It was just the game. And I yearn for those days again, when I can actually say for certain that when I buy something, it is the thing I wanted in the first place, and I will not have to see it get piecemealed out to me over the course of a year, maybe two in some cases. It is not good for consumer confidence, and it is definitely not good for your bottom line. Because again, you're going to have to keep putting the same amount of resources into the game that you were going to anyway, but you're not going to be getting nearly as much for the game itself. And while we're on the subject, be transparent about what you are producing. 76 definitely had this problem. Not really sure if we were creating a multiplayer game or if we were going to get a single player experience. Essentially, they wanted to have it both ways, being able to be something that could be played as a single-player game, except that you never really get the option to do that. And at the same time, you really never get the multiplayer experience that you might have hoped for. Anthem was in development for so long, and yet the studio didn't really even know what the game was going to be until the tail end of development. Sea of Thieves definitely got down the water effects, congratulations, but then they forgot that there should probably be a game in there at some point, and that maybe just playing, you know, the accordion for long periods of time is not going to be great entertainment for the people who are picking it up. And for the record, this does not give you license to work your staff for 100 hours a week to the bone so that you can create that complete gaming experience. I really liked Red Dead Redemption 2, Rockstar, but I had already seen the reports before it came out that the staff was being worked nigh on to death, and I already made a statement before it even came out that, of course, nobody saw because no one follows me or knows who I am, that I would have been perfectly fine with waiting 3, 4, 6 months to get the game if I knew that people weren't just dying and tortured during the process. And I stand by that remark. I am fine with games coming out in 3 months, 6 months, even another year, if it means that the game is going to be complete. Understand that we, as gamers, want that. We want a complete game. And the only reason that you have gotten benefit of the doubt was based on your previous work. This is not a sustainable model for you. You may not care that much about us as consumers anymore. I mean, you probably do in as much as we give you money for a thing. But if you understand anything, it should be that this is not good for your business. This is not a tactic that will end up producing positive results down the road. And this is going to be your downfall. In fact, I would even venture a guess that this will eventually be the downfall of the AAA market if something isn't done soon. And I should say, kudos, hats off to the companies that refuse to engage in this kind of activity. Kudos to Nintendo, kudos to CD Projekt Red for refusing to engage in that and make games that are complete and make them in a fair and equitable way and make them so that they come out when they are done, even if it means that the development cycle is long, to come out with clear visions of what they want to achieve and to go all in on it. And trust me, that eventually will get you rewarded in the long term. But you may not get any instant gratification from it. And perhaps at this point, too many have gone too far down that road for it to really matter. But hopefully for the companies that are still out there that just want to produce great games, the Naughty Dogs, the Insomniacs, the Obsidians of the world, hopefully they will understand how important their reputation is in the ensuing years. Because we are observant. We are watching. We are more aware than ever of who is pulling these stunts. And we are not willing to trust you anymore. And that has got to hurt you where it really counts. The wallet. Sincerely, Nathan, a gamer for 30 years who's more confused about the state of the industry now than he ever has been before. Thank you for watching Vlogging Camp, and don't forget to dislike and unsubscribe, because of course you know that I'm gonna start like a Battlefront 2 model of microtransactions. Do you want some loot boxes? I could give you some loot boxes. No? Of course you don't want those. Let me see if I can get like a cosmetic skin for a frozen banana lightsaber or something. Yeah, that's probably in here. There's money in the lightsaber. This is such an odd time to be a gamer. Like, I've played video games for like 3 decades now, which is a long time, but I've enjoyed most of it. But now seems to be both the best and the worst time to actually be in gaming. On the one hand, there are technological advances that have made these games more cinematic and fully realized, more immersive than they ever have been in the past, ever before. And on the other hand, it is the most frustrating model of delineating out that content that I have ever seen. And the ways that companies are thinking up to make their money now seems so disparate over what it once was. These games that, you know, technologically are profound in what they bring to the table, but also seem so hollow and lifeless when you get them in your hands. I'm very frustrated by it, and I don't know what to do about it, but hopefully by addressing the video game developers and publishers themselves on this video, well, it probably won't do anything. But you know what? I tried. What do you want? You know, like, I don't usually buy all the cosmetic upgrades that people are usually into, but any game that allows me to turn my horse into a unicorn, yeah, here's all my money.